Qualsiasi cosa farò si ritorcerà su di te e sulla mamma. E io non voglio. Dagli ultimi Hunger Games, qualcosa è cambiato. Lo vedo. Che cosa vedi? Speranza.
Ci hai salvati, lo so. Ma sono stanco di recitare per le telecamere, per poi ignorarci nella vita reale.
Lei non è quello che credono. Deve essere eliminata.
Certo, ma nel modo giusto, al momento giusto.
Dobbiamo andare, prima che ci uccidano, perché ci uccideranno.
La gente vuole lottare. Io resto qui.
Lei si è battuta molto bene negli Hunger Games, ma erano giochi. Le piacerebbe una guerra vera? Migliaia di vittime fra la sua gente, i suoi cari morti.
Che cosa devo fare?
Questo è il 75esimo anno degli Hunger Games. I tributi saranno scelti tra i vincitori ancora in vita.
Katniss!
Potevo solo dirti addio!
Katniss!
Cosa faccio io?
Credo che questi giochi saranno diversi.
I 75esimi Hunger Games!
Pronta a lavorare?
Katniss Everdeen, la ragazza di fuoco!
Dimenticate quello che credete di sapere sugli Hunger Games. L'anno scorso è stato facile. Stavolta avrete di fronte tutti assassini esperti.
Un ultimo consiglio?
Resta viva. Ricorda chi è il vero nemico.
Ciao a tutti, siamo qui in diretta al Festival di Roma per raccontarvi la giornata più attesa di questa 8ª edizione del Festival. La giornata è dedicata ad Hunger Games, la ragazza di fuoco, secondo capitolo tratto dalla celebre saga letteraria di Suzanne Collins. Dopo le varie premiere europee, il regista Francis Lawrence e gli interpreti Jennifer Lawrence, Liam Hemsworth e Josh Hutcherson hanno scelto Roma per presentare il loro film, accolti da migliaia di fan in fila alle prime ore del mattino per conoscere i loro idoli. Questo secondo capitolo si ricollega direttamente al finale del primo. Sono passati solo 3 mesi dalla fine della 74esima edizione degli Hunger Games, ma non c'è pace per Katniss e Peeta, coinvolti nuovamente attraverso una terribile iniziativa del presidente Snow in quella che è l'edizione alla memoria, che vede i nostri eroi lottare non contro semplici tributi, ma contro i vincitori delle passate edizioni.
You two have a very simple task.
I never meant for anyone to get killed. He has to know that.
What are you talking about? Who has to know what?
Snow. He came to see me. He's worried about rebellion in the districts. He thinks that they don't believe our love story.
You know, Katniss, you should have told me that before I went out there and tried to give these people the money.
I'm sorry. I didn't know what to do.
Katniss, what were you thinking?
Please, please, just help me get through this trip. Please, just help us get through this.
This trip, girl, wake up. This trip doesn't end when you get back home. You never get off this train. You two are mentors now. From now on, your job is to be a distraction, so people forget what the real problems are.
We'll be right back.
doesn't sound like a cliche. It is a cliche, but I really just love my job. I love making movies. I love acting. So, and I've been taking movies for the same reason my entire life. I love the script. I love the character. It's something that I'm interested in. I want to work with a particular director, and that won't change. I don't really pay attention to the grand scale. I mean, when you say everything like that, it gives me butterflies in my stomach. But it doesn't feel like that. It's just fun. Like I'm just doing a job, and I don't really pay attention to anything written about me at all. That's
right. Whereas Katniss Everdeen, she wants her life back. She wants to survive. She wants to protect her family. And it's what I love about Katniss Everdeen as a hero and as a character is that she feels very human and she feels very relatable. And I think truly men and women can relate because she makes such real and naturalistic choices and choices from the gut and choices that we can believe in. And she's flawed.
Look up to this, you know, Katniss in particular. She's someone who refuses to change. She refuses to give in to this, you know, this evil force that wants her to be something she's not. And she says no, and regardless of whether it's her life at risk, she's willing to stand up for what she believes in, and it's something that Gail does, it's something that Peter does. It's all these real characters that, you know, enough's enough. It's refusing to give in to it. And I think that's an important message for a lot of young people. And, you know, I think that's why, you know, young girls look up to Katniss and it inspires them and gives them courage because, you know, they see that they can be themselves and they can stand up for what they believe in.
Quite honestly, stepping into this project was really exciting to me because of, you know, I've been asked a lot if there was pressure because of the fan base, and I was actually really energized by the fact that there's a fan base. I was also really excited to step into it because the cast that I was going to inherit was fantastic. The only person in the cast that was already established that I knew was Lenny Kravitz. So everybody else was a stranger to me. And I didn't know anything other than they were all really extremely talented people. The great thing is that they accepted me with warmth and kindness and excitement and enthusiasm. And they all just did an unbelievable job, and we all just collaborated together, and I think it was really fruitful and really creative.
Much, and then to find a story like this that has such a mass appeal and is such a complex story with such core values and themes throughout about love and family and fighting for what you believe in, you know, it's a rare thing, and so for me to be a part of it, it's absolutely incredible. And the fans for The Hunger Games have been so supportive from day one. And really, they give us so much energy and drive to keep on going when we're on these victory tours of ours that are very tiring. So it's amazing to be a part of it.
Bene, perché sono riuscito a infilarmi e sono stato in seconda fila lì a red carpet e quindi sono riuscito a avere gli autografi di Liam e del regista perché Josh e Jennifer non si sono fermati.
Perché è diverso, non è uguale a tutti gli altri film, cioè proprio qualcosa. E poi è adatta all'età nostra, quindi è proprio bello.
Just Cinema!